Hello, I'm Martin Smith, and this is your UFX Markets Week in Review. Today we'll discuss some of the major financial events of the past week and how they impacted the currency and commodity markets. The euro appreciated against all of its major counterparts after EU finance ministers decided to place the area's major lenders under the authority of the European Central Bank. Further boosting the euro's upward trend was last week's two-day EU summit meeting on the currency union, during which leaders indicated their resolution regarding failed banks could very well be reached before June 2013. The euro was last trading at the level of 131.61, an increase of 0.65%. The pound continued to appreciate against the US dollar after a Bank of England official said the economy will improve. Positive news about the UK housing market further boosted the pound. According to the prominent industry group, housing prices will likely rise in 2013. Although Standard & Poor's decided to lower the UK's credit rating on Thursday, the pound continued to appreciate against most of its counterparts, with investors saying the S&P's decision is unlikely to cause significant setbacks. The pound was last trading at the level of 161.66, an increase of 0.35%. The Japanese yen continued its downward spiral against the US dollar, with Japanese opposition leader Shinzo Abe projected to win Sunday's election. Shinzo, an advocate of aggressive stimulus, is expected to put significant pressure on the Bank of Japan to lower its currency. According to the Bank of Japan, the Tankan index for large companies fell to its lowest level since March. The Japanese yen was last trading at 83.50, a decrease of 0.16%. In commodities, oil recorded another weekly gain, its fifth since November 2nd, as the manufacturing sector grew in both the United States and China. Positive news about the health of the US economy, coupled with the manufacturing data from China, suggests a bullish market for oil. Oil was last trading at 86.73, an increase of 0.98%. Gold dropped to a one-week low as anxiety about the fiscal cliff deadlock in the US prompted some investors to sell. Although lawmakers are saying it's increasingly unlikely that an agreement will be reached before the Christmas holiday, investors are keeping a close eye on the negotiations. The Fed sent strong signals about continuing its lax monetary policies, which should lead to higher gold prices in the future. Gold was last trading at $1,695.93 an ounce, a decrease of 0.05%. Well, that's all we have time for today. I hope you've enjoyed this week's review and you'll join us next week. Until then, be sure to visit us at ufxmarkets.com for all of your online trading needs. For UFX Markets, I'm Martin Smith. Good luck and happy trading.